So one of the things I have talked about before on my channel is using CineMatch to match color profiles and camera sensors from between different cameras. So basically just matching the footage that you shoot from one camera to another. So what I'm going to do is go through and show you the workflow that I would use in order to basically do that, match the footage from the A7 III to the A7S III. I've already brought two clips onto the timeline, so I'm using the A7S III on the top layer and the A7 III on the bottom layer. And just so that you guys can easily see the difference, I'm just gonna do a split screen. So I'm gonna put the A7S III on the left and I'll put the A7 III on the right. And the first thing that you wanna do is go and find CineMatch. So if you go to the effects panel and start typing in CineMatch, you can just drop it onto both clips. And so the first thing that I'm going to do is set my target camera for both cameras, and then I'm going to apply a Rec 709 transformation so that you can see the difference between the two clips. So first one, A7 III, let me just go and choose my source camera from here. So finding the Sony A7 III, and I shot in S-Log2, that one. And then I'm gonna do the same thing for, and then sorry, just apply Rec 709 to that clip. And I'm gonna do the same thing for the A7S III. So I'm gonna select that, Sony A7S III. And I shot in S-Log3, that one. And then also apply the Rec 709 over that one. So already it's kind of color corrected, but the A7 III is a little bit more exposed. So I'm just going to bring the exposure down so it kind of matches the A7 III footage. Too many A7s and 3s. So yeah, bring it down a bit. So once I've kind of just adjusted the exposure, I would then go to my target setting, my target camera setting, and set the A7 III to match the A7S III footage. So I'm going to choose the A7S III from this target settings and set it to the same settings that I shot with the A7S III. So you might have been able to see there was a little jump in the skin tones. There was a little jump in the skin tones here. So it's basically started trying to match the footage. And what I'm also going to do is just bring the temperature down a little bit, because the one on the A7 III footage looks a little bit warm. So that's one of the cool things that you can do as well. You can just further tweak it to try and match it a little bit better. So once you've done that, that's pretty much all you need to do, apart from just going in and tweaking it if you think that it just needs a little bit more matching. But after that, then I would go and I just grab an adjustment layer, drop it over the top, and this is where I would then apply FilmConvert. So if you go back up to the effects panel, grab FilmConvert, FilmConvert Nitrate, drop that on the top, and it's already applied it just using the default camera settings, but because we already have our camera settings, I'm gonna go in and choose Sony A7S III. So if you were just color grading and you hadn't applied Rec 709, you would go in and choose the color profile that you shot the footage in. But because I've already applied Rec 709, you want to choose the Rec 709 profile. So hit apply, and then that drops it on for you. And then from here, it's just a case of just going through and basically grading the footage how you want it to look. You can choose different film stocks here, and just see what you kind of want to do. So I'm just going to stick with the first one, KD5207 Vis 3, and just start playing around with the look. Maybe just bring that down a little bit. I could even just change this temperature. That looks better. And you've got some color correction settings in here as well. So you can adjust things like your shadows, midtones, highlights, the saturation, you've got curves, you've got levels, And the other thing is that you can also generate a 3D LUT. So if you know that this is a look that you're going to use a lot for this camera setting, then you can actually just generate that LUT, and then you can just bring it in and just drop it on instead of having to go through this entire process every single time. So this is without FilmConvert, this is with FilmConvert. And again, I've just realized I've taken the film off. So yeah, let me just tweak it a little bit more. It's how I want it to look. So before FilmConvert, after FilmConvert. And it just gives the footage a really nice film look. So do go and check out CineMatch. If you use the code TamaraG, you will get a 10% discount. So that also works for both CineMatch and FilmConvert, which are both great plugins. And as you've seen, that's what I use for my entire workflow. So I hope you found the video useful. If you do give it a like. And if you have any questions or anything, just drop them in the comments. But thanks for watching.